Today, I'm flying from Tokyo Narita to Zurich with Swiss on their Boeing 777-300ER in business class. Swiss business class has been on my bucket list for a while, even though it isn't considered the best in both hard and soft products compared to some other leading airlines. Check-in and security went quickly and smoothly, thanks to the dedicated counter for business class passengers, and there are even a fast-track security lane for Star Alliance Gold members. There are three lounges for Star Alliance business class passengers and Gold members, two ANA lounges and one United Club. Even though the United Club was closest to my gate, I went for the ANA lounge, which is located on level 4 of the Satellite 5 terminal near gate 51, just past security. The lounge is incredibly spacious, featuring a stunning panoramic view of the runway. Immediately upon entering, you notice an island with high top chairs and a spacious seating area. There's also a long hallway that leads to another section of the lounge, with even more seating options. Showers are available at the lounge. You can book a shower room using the machine in the main area. I didn't get the chance to try them though. The main buffet area is located immediately to the right as you enter the lounge, offering a wide range of choices. You find Japanese options like onigiri, along with pastries, sandwiches, and a salad bar. Additionally, a hot buffet area serves ANA's original chicken curry and rice. My favorite though was the noodle bar. It offers 7 different noodle dishes, from soba to udon and ramen, with an additional vegetable curry. After ordering, you receive a buzzer that notifies you when your dish is ready. I went with the ramen with pork broth, which was incredibly delicious. It was a wonderful way to enjoy a final bowl of ramen before departing Japan. I don't usually drink beer in a lounge, but I couldn't resist trying the beer machine. Watching it tilt the glass, create the perfect head of foam, was quite amusing. Boarding started around scheduled time. First group 1, which included first class passengers and home circle members, and soon after group 2, consisting of business class passengers, senators, and Star Alliance Gold members. Upon boarding, a flight attendant welcomed me and guided to my seat, 12 kilo. This seat was one of the front seats, and I was lucky to reserve the seat for free. Swiss Boeing 777-300ER seats 320 passengers, 8 first class, 62 business class, 24 premium economy, and 226 in economy class. Business class included 62 seats arranged across 2 cabins. The main cabin consisted of 10 rows with 5 seats each, plus 2 additional seats in row 6. The mini cabins offers 2 rows of 5 seats each. The seat configuration alternates between 1-2-2 and 2-2-1 layout. The front seats are best option for solo travelers, offering shelves on either side, increased privacy, and generous storage space. These seats can be selected in advance for free by miles and more on circle members and senators. Other passengers must pay or wait until check-in opens to select the front seat for free. I managed to reserve one of the seats as soon as check-in opened on the Lufthansa app. The middle section pairs of seats also offer generous space, each with large console table. In contrast, the window side pairs of seats provide less space, as they share a single console table. Due to this configuration, many passengers lack direct aisle access. There are 12 pairs of seats along the cabin window sides, making them a better choice for couple or anyone traveling with a companion. Alright, let's take a detailed seat tour. Swiss used Thomson Vantage seats with custom finishes for business class on all their long-haul aircrafts, including the 777. The design is clean and simple, with dark fabric seats, white plastic dividers, and wood veneer. However, I find the design somewhat outdated compared to other airline business class in the market. In front of the seat, you find a 16-inch HD touchscreen with a small storage compartment beneath. The WIFI screen could tilt forward and backward, allowing you to watch the screen in different angles. On the left side of the screen was a large literature pocket for magazine and other items. The footwell beneath was slightly narrow when in lie-flat bed mode, but comfortable enough for sitting. It is worth mentioning that the front seats have small footwell compared to the other seats. The left side of my seat was the side console, featuring several useful elements, like a hook for a headphone, a seat number hanger for jacket to be identified by the crew, and a strap for securing documents or a tablet. There are also a water bottle holder, a decorative light, a flip-out reading light, and a headphone jack. The side console also had a sliding compartment that can be opened for additional storage. The tray table release button was located on the bottom of the side console. The tray table extends from seat's left side and could be folded over in half. Beneath the side console were the seat controls, including button for preset, takeoff and landing, lounging, and lie flat bed mode. Under a flap were controls for lumbar support, seat cushion firmness, and massage function. The WIFI remote controller were a standard Panasonic touchscreen model, and it was stored inside the center console behind the seat controls. Beneath the side console was a universal power outlet with an USB-A port. To the right side of my seat, there was a large counter that easily could hold books or laptops for the entire flight. Above the counter was an open storage area, perfect for storing smaller items. Beneath the counter were two storage compartments, one exposed for easy access and another for fully enclosed for more secure storage. It's worth noting that there were no individual air nostrils, which was quite disappointing as the cabin was uncomfortably warm during the flight. Upon boarding, I found pillow, blanket, amenity kit, and a pair of slippers already waiting at my seat. Shortly afterward, the crew came around with pre-departure beverages. I opted for the champagne, which came in a proper glassware. Soon after, the crew provided warm towels and handed out the flight menus. With the door closed, the safety video played as we commenced our pushback. If you like this kind of content and want to see more, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Your support helps our channel grow so we can create even more videos. Thanks for your support. Soon after takeoff, the flight attendant came through the cabin to take the meal orders. The menu reads as follows. The meal service began as the crew rolled carts down the aisle for initial drink service. I opted for another glass of champagne and sparkling water, paired with serving of mixed nuts. There were two appetizer options, and I opted for the roast duck breast. The starter was not only delicious and appetizing, but also beautifully presented. There were also a basic cheese plate consisting of two types of cheese, three grapes, and a side salad with appetizer. My rating, 9 out of 10. For the main course, I opted for the seared halibut with herb risotto. Even though I usually avoid fish meals on planes, I decided to try it out since halibut is one of my favorite fish. Unfortunately, the fish itself was bland, but the sauce helped a bit, and the risotto was undercooked, so it was unedible. My rating, 4 out of 10. For dessert, I opted for the chocolate and raspberry cake. Unfortunately, the cake was only average, and it tasted like something you find at a grocery store. My rating, 3 out of 10. After dinner, a flight attendant came through the cabin with a box of chocolate. The meal service began impressively with a delicious appetizer, but the rest of the meal was just disappointing. It's hard to top such great dining experience, especially having enjoyed wonderful food in Japan. Alright, let's check out the lavatory. There are three lavatories available for business class passengers, located between the two cabins. Two were located on the right side of the aircraft, while the third one was on the left side. These lavatories were basic and fairly small, with tissues, hand lotion, and a face mist. I decided to test out the bed and take a nap, so I adjusted the seat to lie flat bed mode. The bed is somewhat narrow and the footwell was on the smaller side. I found it difficult to bend my knees while sleeping, since I usually sleep on the side. Another thing that the bed was quite hard, although I usually prefer a firmer seat to a softer one, but this seat was noticeably hard. Since it already was early afternoon in Japan, I found it hard to fall asleep, so I decided to adjust the seat to its upright position and check out the IFE and Wi-Fi. Swiss in-flight entertainment system had a limited selection. While there were several new movies releases and some older films, the entertainment selection itself was just okay, but it didn't match the extensive offerings of airlines like Qatar or Singapore. Wi-Fi was available on this flight, but it required a purchase. There were four different pricing options based on intent data usage. I struggled to connect with my phone, but worked fine on my laptop. Given a high cost just for testing the connection, I decided to drop that test. The Amenity ticket from Victorinox was quite basic. The tin box contained a pair of socks, earplugs, toothpaste, lip balm, toothbrush, and eye shades. One of the flight attendants made rounds offering snacks and drinks. The first round they served Häagen-Dazs ice cream, which was refreshing since the cabin was very warm. The second serving was a beef sandwich, which was just okay. There was a self-serve snack bar in the galley, but it only had sweet items, and I started to feel hungry again. I asked the flight attendant if there were any other options available, but they had run out of chips and sandwiches. Considering this is a 14-hour flight and the next meal won't be served until just before landing, and it's surprising that Swiss doesn't offer any light meal options for such a long flight. After catching a few hours sleep, the second meal service started 2 hours before landing, beginning with hot towels. And for my arrival meal, I opted for pasta. The pasta was delicious, and it might have tasted even better because of my hunger. My rating, 9 out of 10. I always wanted to try Swiss Boeing 777 business class. I knew it wasn't the most exciting business class product compared to what other airlines offered, so I didn't have the highest expectation. The overall flight experience was below average. In comparison to what you can get on flights from Japan, like ANA Business Class, The Room, Swiss Hard product falls short. However, the Swiss front seat was much better than anticipated. It was spacious, plenty of storage options, and decent privacy. The main issue was the bed, which was hard and narrow. The soft product was generally mediocre. Although the appetizer and arrival meal were excellent, the rest of the meal was disappointing. It was surprising and disappointing that Swiss didn't offer a light meal menu on a 14-hour long flight. The flight attendant offered sweets, items, and drinks throughout the flight, which helped a bit. However, I would have preferred something more substantial to eat rather than just sweets. Speaking of service, the service was typical for a European carrier, so it wasn't as personalized as top Asian carriers. However, the crew was friendly and professional, and I appreciated their proactive approach to drink refills. Overall, I had a pleasant flight experience, but I wouldn't specifically seek out Swiss Business Class again until the new Swiss Senses product is introduced. We hope you enjoyed watching our video and sharing our incredible flight with Swiss Business Class on their 777-300ER. Consider to like or subscribe to our channel, and we look forward to bringing you more amazing content in the future. Until then, take care and see you next time.